You do not look so bad. Then, in the car, I doubted you would survive.
This about the biochip? That why I'm here?
I hear it's damaged beyond repair. Any attempt to extract it would be disastrous. Fatal for you.
Vic likes to talk, I guess.
Not many could do what he did. You should be thankful.
Why'd you help me anyway?
I needed you to leave. That hasn't changed.
What's it you actually want from me?
To begin, you must tell me where to find Evelyn Parker.
Evelyn, what's she to you?
She and Yorinobu Arasaka had intimate relations. She knows how to get to him.
Been thinking I ought to have a word with her myself. She promised to help me get rid of the chip.
I would not count on that. She's likely gone, very far away.
Why you figure she skipped town?
I tried to locate her, but had no success. I suspect she covered her tracks. You said Parker could help you remove the relic. Does she work for a corporation?
Don't think so, no.
Can you expand?
Don't matter how much perfume a Corpo sprays on mornings. By lunch, that's replaced by the stench of skullduggery. Only thing I caught from Evelyn was determination.
And I do stink of skullduggery?
Nope. You're starting to stink. Period. Sorry, I couldn't be of any help. Don't have any time to lose.
Wait. I need you. Yorinobu Arasaka must answer for this crime of patricide.
Looking for justice? In Night City?
I seek revenge. Much more feasible here. I have allies prepared to bring Yorinobu to his knees. The only thing I need is proof.
And you think they'll trust the word of a merc?
I have nothing better now. Also, I know no one here. And I am a fugitive. I am hunted.
What if I say no?
Then I will tell you what rewards await if you help me.
So what, we stroll into Arasaka HQ and announce that Yorinobu's a kin killer? That he murdered Zbro?
We'll get the hearing before reasonable people in a neutral location. Certain procedures will be used to establish the truth.
A lie detector? Forget it.
In that case, another option. You are dying. You do not know how to save yourself. A chip, the relic, is a culprit. Technology made by Arasaka. Technology they alone know. This corporation can save you as easily as it can make you disappear. It is merely about getting the right people on your side. Politics.
You mean people like Anders Hellman?
You know this name? How?
Prepped for the heist thoroughly. Relic is Hellman's design, his creation.
Untrue. He's a pawn. I was thinking of one much more powerful. Besides, Anders Hellman escaped to Arasaka, betrayed it.
Hanako-sama, owai dekite koei desu.
Kochira koso.
Now, Hanako-sama, I would first like to ask you.
Fucking Sokka scums everywhere.
Hey, I was listening to that.
Shut up. Nobody except you wants to watch that shit about that Corpo cunt.
What did you say?
You heard me.
Let it go, Takamura.
At least one of you's got some fucking sense.
The last thing we want to do is
I'm sorry. How stupid the reflex.
Thanks for the offer. Need to think about it. Get back to you.
I need time to plan, organize. You stand to gain much if you help me. All I ask is that you do not leave the city.
Leave? Why would I leave? Need help. Best chance I'll find the right person here.
Someone other than Arasaka specialist? There's no one. No alternative.
Actually, we just talked about some. With a bit of luck, I'll track down Evelyn.
If she could not help you before, she will not manage to now.
Honor among thieves. Ever heard of it?
Yes. I thought it ironic. Thieves have none. There's just honor, I believe.
You're a Nobu Arasaka degree, I'm sure.
The Parker woman will not help you. Why are you? I would think about a plan B.
Anders Hellman. He invented the relic. If I want to get rid of it, he's my man. And if that means picking another fight with Arasaka, so be it.
Hellman defected from the company. I myself spent many days looking for him. He... what's the expression? Dropped off the face of the earth.
Defected? Where to? Some other corp poach him?
As far as I can tell, he acted alone. A meticulous man. He planned it. Covered his tracks very well.
Any idea where he took off to?
None.
Somebody's been busy the last few days.
I will not sit and do nothing when there is information to be found. Things to prepare.
Your job, basically.
It was my job.
Why are you looking for Hellman?
He was the one to alert Zbro-san to Yorinobu's schemes. He knew both of them well and could be an important witness.
Corpo rats squeal when hanging by their tails.
For several days, I collected the information. All leads point to one place, the club called the Afterlife. I was quickly dismissed by the Queen of Fixers there, Rogue.
Mean to say you worked for Zbro, yet got no idea how to talk to the High and Mighty.
She wished to have nothing to do with the man accused of murdering Zbro Arasaka.
Rogue's well informed. Gets wind of most things that happen in the city. Might be worth asking her about Hellman.
I wish you luck. The woman is choosy, expensive, and rude. I cannot stay here any longer. Do what you want. Look for Parker, Hellman, whoever. I must see some friends, call in some favors. When my people in Arasaka are ready to listen, I will call you.
Till then, I guess.
If by some miracle you find Hellman, please notify me. He and I have unfinished business.
Zapper dumples and filth. In some ways, Night City never changes. Arasaka's still a despotic machine, and the world's on a collision course with chaos. But hey, at least Rogue's still alive.
You know, you've got some nerve. First you're out to kill me, now you want to be my pal and make like nothing happened?
You know you don't gotta speak out loud to talk to me.
Do you want?
And I've processed some shit, changed my mind. Don't want you dead anymore.
Go fuck yourself, dickwipe.
Hey, wasn't easy for me either. You woke up in a landfill, I woke up in your head, wrestling with your thoughts, memories. Think we're even. And I've taken a step back, looked at things. Think we might be able to help each other. We could start with Rogue. Her and I go back to the Stone Age.
Why should I trust you? Remind me again.
Trust me, don't trust me. I don't give a fuck. It's the least of our worries, anyway.
You are the ghost of Christmas past, asshole. Any friends you've had are either dead or so old their memory's gone.
Johnny Silverhand died a legend. Nobody forgets that.
So you fucking know Rogue. What would I say to her? I got a talking brain tumor, claims it's her old friend Johnny?
Trust me, Rogue's heard dumber shit than that. Way back when you weren't even an itch in your daddy's ball sack.
Don't need convincing. Seen your memories. Gross.
Rogue will dance to any tune I play or just get us to the afterlife.
There is no us.
Hey, look. Would you look at that? You see it too, right?
Either gone completely whacked or I'm having a mystical moment.
What's that chick's name? The one with the hair?
Misty?
Yes? What's up?
More likely a neuron misfire for Victor to check out. Or maybe ask them both.
So soon? How's your afternoon? But you are not the masters of your memories!
Saw a weird image out on the street. Seems like your line of work.
What'd it look like?
Grabbed a scan, take a look.
Tarot. Major Arcanum. What you saw was a sign from a higher power.
The what now? Major Arcanum?
Tarot card, archetype, knowledge held in symbolic form, a stage in your journey through life. Take your pick.
Either way, you're saying some higher power is talking to me through tarot cards?
Or to Silverhand. Or both of you, seeing as you form a harmonious whole at the moment.
Be a little easier if this higher power learned to be direct.
Well, the world is a maze of illusions. It's not easy for the light to shine into the prison of our earthly existence.
Right, great. So what do I do with a sign I can't understand from a power I know nothing about?
I'd start by looking for more of them. The tarot describes a road, so go down it.
Still don't know what I'm supposed to do with what I find.
Look for more images. They must have some connection to the place where you find them. Think about what you see. You ask me? They've been sent to help you find the truth.
Oh, finding the truth is pretty far down on my list at the moment.
A difficult time is coming when you'll have to choose which road to take. Then, you'll understand.
Dunno.
Come on back when you've found more. I'll help you decipher what you've seen.
Or rather, not only. Eyes do not belong to you, or rather, not only to you. those who have sold you your mechanical eyes have resisted the temptation to peek through them?
Me? That you? Shit. Thought you were gone.
You're not alone in thinking me dead. Thought it was game over for me, too.
Things went ass up, huh? Not as planned.
About the heist, I take it. Must have talked to Evelyn.
Didn't need to. Old damn city's hurt.
Listen, need to find Evelyn.
I really don't want to talk about her.
Know where she is?
What'd I just say? Drop it. I won't tell you again.
Can we meet? Let's meet, please. You at Lizzie's? Listen, don't laugh, but I've been seeing some weird shit around town. Like, murals or something. But no, they're not real.
Just a Kuroshi blip. Could take a look.
No. No, images are too complex for a blip. It's like they're symbols.
That case is the biochip. Brain can't handle the data overload. Either that, or it's reached the cortex.
Can you do anything?
Nope. Better find a way to get rid of that chip.
Got a few questions about Silverhand and this chip.
I'm no expert, but fire away. See what I can do.
Tried to flatline me. Johnny did.
What?
What can I do to suppress him? You know, avoid my murder?
Well, long as you don't give him control, can't do too much harm. Of course, that won't necessarily be possible after some time.
And what then?
What do you say we don't let things get that far? Find a way to get rid of Silverhand, and fast.
Why am I reliving Johnny's memories?
You two share a brain now. He has access to your senses, perceptions, even some memories. Likewise, you've got a glimpse into his. After a while, won't even know whose is whose.